All right, so in this video, I'm gonna be talking about how I got into the MCIT program at the University of Pennsylvania. I'll be talking about my stats, relevant experience, and other related stuff. So, just as a reminder, the MCIT program, otherwise known as the Master of Computer and Information Technology program at UPenn, is an advanced master's program in computer science designed for people without a background in computer science. All right, so some stats about me. I majored in philosophy at the University of Arizona. I also completed honors, so I did an honors thesis, and my GPA was 3.536. Now, I also took the GRE and submitted it for my application, and I had pretty kind of decent results. I mainly submitted it and took it because I was able to afford it, and it showed some evidence for quantitative ability because I don't really have a traditional quantitative degree. All right, so for the GRE, I got on my verbal 153 out of 170, which is 60th percentile for that group. Quantitative, I got 161 out of 170 for 76th percentile. And in analytical, I got 4.5 out of 6 and 81st percentile. So here, I did much better on the writing portion, the analytical portion of the test. I like writing essays and reading a lot, hence philosophy. And I did decently well in verbal and quantitative. Obviously my quantitative was 161 out of 170, so I was pretty happy about that to get into the 160s range. But yeah, those were my GRE scores. All right, so now for some relevant coursework experience. Now, a majority of the classes I took in college were philosophy, obviously with my major, and I took a whole bunch of other courses along with that. But related to computing and computer science, I took probably three related courses. So I took two introductory programming courses, one in Python and then one in R, and not much after that. But that did tell me what I was interested in, and it actually helped me get a TA ship, which I'll later talk about. Now, the third course that's relevant that I took was actually a graduate course in deep learning. Very briefly, deep learning is a type of machine learning, and I was particularly attracted to that class because I wanted to learn more about machine learning and then possibly applications in data science. Now, I took it as a grad course because I wanted a really rigorous introduction, and the only way I got into that course was through special permission by the instructor. I really had to make a case as a non-computer information science major and not a graduate student to take that course. And I'm very happy and grateful that I got into that course, and I did well in all three of those courses that I just mentioned. Now, I want to talk about some relevant experience that I put into my application, namely my teaching experience and research experience. As I've mentioned before, after taking an introductory programming Python course, I was invited to be what's known as a section leader. That's just another word for undergraduate teaching assistant. And I helped have labs, hold office hours, grade assignments, proctor exams, so on and so forth. And I did that for around 4 semesters, teaching introductory Python and intro to data science. So that was a lot of fun, and I really think that helped me in developing not only my passion for computing and programming, especially data science, but also show some ability that I can get through a program about computing. I know a little bit about what it means to teach for students, and specifically with this program as well. I also taught online twice, and I think that really helps me to learn and get through an online program as well. Now, I was also the head TA or head section leader for 1 semester, and where I mentored other teaching assistants, and that was a very fun experience, and I learned a lot, how to manage effectively, how to teach others, not only students, but other teachers as well, and just how to have fun. Like, it's really exciting to learn how to make lots of courses more fun and interactive and ultimately help students learn. Now, finally, I want to talk about my research. So I was in a bioinformatics lab for around 2 years, and that was very fun. I was initially interested in joining it because I wanted to learn how to apply what I've learned, not only through learning, but also through teaching, but actually work on projects, research projects. And so through that lab, I was able to have one peer-reviewed publication, and then also I published something else in an undergraduate journal. And I also presented an oral presentation and a poster presentation at an undergraduate research conference. So I did basically a lot of biomedical data science stuff. So applying the tools that I've learned in Python and R on data sets that were related to hospital data, patient data, and that was a lot of fun. And I really think I learned a lot through that experience that I didn't really get through a lot of coursework. Now, one of the main things that I took away from this and kind of wrote in my application was kind of the aptitude I developed and wanting to learn more. I felt like I got a lot of chances and opportunities to apply maybe introductory or some skills I had in data science and Python and scripting, but I didn't really have a foundation in computer science. I had a lot of extensive experience in coursework, even taking a graduate course at one point, but I couldn't really be applying lots of foundational computer science topics or maybe engineering terms. I didn't really know much besides basic kind of visualizations and statistics that I would use with programming. So that's one of the main reasons why I applied to this program. And one of the reasons why I also stated, although I have all this experience, I still want to learn more, and I only have a very narrow knowledge, and I want to expand upon that. And that's one of the main reasons why I wanted to join this program, I wanted to apply to it, and that was kind of my whole reasoning behind that and showing my experience. So what do you guys think? Is there a similar program that you're applying to, or is it MCIT? Do you have a different background, maybe that's not so quantitative? And what do you guys think? I'm very happy to share more about what I've learned about this whole application progress in my previous college experience. But if you want to see more, please let me know and please consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.